This week we're up at Barmer Mill National Park on the Murray River undertaking crayfish surveys to better understand a threatened species. To monitor crayfish in the river, we use manana nets, so they're baited with liver. We have floats attached to ropes. We throw the manana nets in. We leave them for a period of 2 hours. We then pull the manana nets back in, collect the crayfish, which we then weigh, sex, measure, and we use that data to feed into our models to provide information to protect crayfish into the future.
As the species are actually declining around a lot of their geographic distribution in the Murray, largely it's been because of inappropriate flood regimes or poor water quality, loss of habitat, and especially overfishing. Because of such a slow growing species, fishing pressure can dramatically reduce their population levels. They can grow to about 30 centimetres or a kilogram in weight. But historically, they would get up to 3.5 kilos. They're actually the second largest crayfish species in the world. They're a big detritus feeder. That means all the rotting vegetation that would otherwise cause poor water quality. They're in there eating all that vegetation. And any animals that die, any fish or etc., they'll eat rotting meat. So they basically cleanse the river of things that could cause pollution for us. The Living Murray Initiative has been a really great program of providing funding for both monitoring and research, but also on-ground management.
So the data we collect today is really, really important. It helps us to manage fish populations and crayfish populations into the future. The best way to help this species really is to follow the fishing regulations. Follow the size limits, follow the take limits so that we can see this species continue on for the next 100 years.